Hi, and welcome to Does This Have Gum In It? In this installment, we're going to be looking at syrups that sweeten beverages. We've got two glasses of tea here and two different kinds of syrup. Now, I know that this one is fully sugared and has no gum in it, so it makes me think this one may have gum in it. So does the no sugar version have gum in it?
Absolutely, yes. In order to replace all of those textural characteristics that we took out of this product when we removed the sugar, we had to use hydrocolloids to replace that mouthfeel.
Okay, so we all know about sweetness that comes with sugar or corn syrup. And we also know about artificial sweeteners that replace the sweetness. But there are other things associated with sugar that have nothing to do with sweetness, but that are just as important.
Absolutely right. When you have a full sugar beverage, you get a lot of mouthfeel characteristics out of that. Mouth coating, that flavor transfer, the density of that solution on your tongue. And you have to find a way to mimic that when you remove those solids.
So when you want to mimic a texture that also has certain types of stability, if you can see the particulate in the syrup, how do you do that?
So we have to pay attention to the dual functionality of hydrocolloids in this. First, we have to make sure it's stable. We have to provide it stability in terms of pulp suspension. And then secondarily, we're going to pay attention to how that individual hydrocolloid affects the textural characteristics, and then build on top of that to make sure that we don't miss any important ones.
Okay, so how do you characterize the textural attributes of this so you can engineer that?
We're going to do a texture map. So right from the beginning, we're going to take our control sample. We're going to look at it visually, we're going to look at it mechanically, and we're going to look at it from an oral perspective. First in your mouth, a few times in your mouth, and how you swallow it.
Okay. So as I look at these, they look very similar in these containers.
Yes.
So I guess the thing to do now is use them the way they're supposed to be used.
That's right.
In the tea.
Yes, let's give them a try. So I'm going to just put them right in here. Just going to give them a quick stir. Make sure everything's uniform. And then you can have a good sip.
All right. Now, I've never tried these
right
until just now, so you'll get honest feedback. That tastes good. It's sweet and kind of fruity tasting. That's good, too, but I get a different flavor. It seems like it's a little sweeter, a little more intense than the no-sugar version. Why is that?
Every time you change the solid level in a suspension like this, you're actually going to affect that flavor transmission in your mouth. So when you reduce your solids and you change it out to artificial sweeteners, you actually tend to get better flavor transfer.
Okay. So for the benefit of those of you watching, if you use gums and hydrocolloids, you can replace the texture and stability that dissolved sugar brings, and you reduce calories. And this one actually had no sugar.
Correct. This had no sugar.
Well, thanks, Maureen, for helping out. And thanks to all of you for watching. Does This Have Gum In It?